He is an author, activist, and actor who you know as Jonathan from 30 Rock. He is also the voice of Baljeet in the animated series Phineas and Ferb. Now he has a new movie. Welcome, Maulik Pancholy. How are you? Good morning.
I am good. Thanks so much for having me on. How are you?
I'm so good. You know, it's so interesting because you are an author, actor, voice actor. You do so much. You're so busy. How have you kept yourself entertained during the quarantine? I'm guessing you were probably working on different projects.
Well, I did have a few things to work on. I wrote a book, as you said, that came out last year, and we're adapting it for television right now. I actually have a copy of it right here. So I've been doing a lot of writing over the break, also working on a second book. And then, of course, the big thing is that we actually finished recording the Phineas and Ferb movie during the quarantine. So, you know, at a time when so many people are out of work and so many actors especially have very few projects to work on. I felt very, very lucky that Disney sent us microphones and they sent us like little home recording kits. And we were able to finish this movie that's going to be premiering on August 28th in just a few days.
You couldn't have set it up better. We actually have a clip from that. So let's take a look at the movie really quickly.
In episode 206B of Space Adventure, they were able to go through an ion barrier without a shield by spinning the USS Minotaur and scattering the ions as they went.
I'm not sure that would work in real life.
Well, I am sure that the writers of Space Adventure have a better grasp of astrophysics than you. Or even me, because I do not see how the science would work either, but hold on!
So good. No, you brought the book up earlier called The Best at It, and it's talking about a young boy who comes out as gay and he's an Indian American. You said you were going to be transitioning that to TV. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well, you know how the TV world works. Like, everything is still in development, but we're hoping to turn it into a family comedy that focuses around the kid, of course, but also around his parents and his supportive community. He's got a grandfather in the book who's one of my favorite characters, who's turns out to be like his best friend in the book. So we're really expanding the world of it. And, you know, hopefully we'll be able to give you more specific details and hopefully you'll be able to watch it really soon. But, you know, it's exciting to me because I think, like Baljeet on Phineas and Ferb, I certainly think that we need more characters, diverse characters on television. And certainly this character is Indian American. He's dealing with his sexuality. And so I think there's a lot in him that kids across the country will be able to relate to.
Right. Oh, that's great. I know that you guys got together for a reunion recently, you and the 30 Rock gang. Would we ever see anything of you guys coming back to TV, any kind of a reboot or anything?
That's so funny that you say that. I did an interview with Tina Fey while we were in the midst of getting this onto the air, and someone asked Tina that, and she was like, I don't know about a whole reboot, but maybe every now and then we could do one of these reunion episodes, because we all had such a good time putting it together. And that was also something that was really fun to get to do during the quarantine. You know, we got to make a TV series, and it was kind of incredible that it all came together so well. When I watched it, I was like, this kind of looks like real TV, and we did it on Zoom mostly.
Right.
So it was really exciting.
Thank you so much for joining us. It was really great. Good luck with everything, your new projects. And you guys can stream Phineas and Ferb, the movie Candace Against the Universe, starting Friday on Disney+. Thank you again. Back to you guys in the studio.